गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, आई एम योर असिस्टेंट टीचर ऑफ क्लास 8। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डू चैप्टर नंबर 1 ऑफ सिविक्स विच इज ऑन पेज नंबर 134। ओपन पेज नंबर 134। चैप्टर नेम इज नेशनल इंटीग्रेशन। इंडिया इज वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्रीज इन द वर्ल्ड। Its culture is termed as the best in the history of the world. India is a land of variety and diversity. India has diverse geographical and cultural features. India's diversity in geographical features. Diversities are seen in landscapes, climate, natural vegetation and soil. There are high mountains, plateaus and lowlands in India. Different climates prevail in India. We see thorny bushes in Rajasthan and dense forest in Assam. India's diversity in cultural factors. Diversities are seen in languages, races, religion and caste. Indians speak numerous languages. While Hindi, Marathi, Gujarati, Punjabi, Urdu and Bengali are the major languages spoken in North India. Tamil, Malayalam, Telugu, Oriya and Kannada are the major languages spoken in South India. Many famous literature were written in various languages. Sanskrit works like Valmiki's Ramayan, Kalidas, Abhigyan, Shakuntalam and Tamil words like Kamba, Ramayan, Thiruvalluvar's Thirukkural are appreciated and enjoyed by all the Indians irrespective of caste, religion and language. Hundreds of minor languages and tribal languages are also spoken in India. Tribal languages have no scripts. People of India have the right to preserve their culture and language. India celebrates different festivals like Deepavali, Ramzan, Christmas, Guru Nanak Jayanti, Buddha Purnima, Mahavir Jayanti, Eid, etc. throughout the whole country. These festivals are celebrated by people of different religions. In spite of the differences, the Indians practice religious tolerance. Now come to next page, page number 135. Because of the differences in climate, cultivation of crops also differ. Based on the crops cultivated, the food habits differ from one place to another. So, rice is the staple food in many southern states, whereas wheat becomes the staple food in the northern states of India. Unity and diversity and national integration. National integration means a feeling of oneness and unity among the people of the country, where all citizens, irrespective of any culture, live together peacefully. The national integration paved the way for the people to work together for the development of country. It also provides strength to fight against the evil forces like communalism and terrorism. National integration in India. In spite of the geographical and cultural differences, the wonderful element of unity binds all the people together. India's unity is a special feature of our culture. We simplify call this as unity in diversity. The feeling of unity in diversity is named as national integration in India. Irrespective of differences in caste, religion and language, we all take pride in calling ourselves as Indian and then as Hindus, Punjabis, Sikhs, Tamilians, Keralites, Christians and Muslims. The feeling we have within us as Indians helps us to forget the difference and live in unity. The secular character of our government permits the people to celebrate the different religious festivals peacefully. Factors promoting national integration. Our customs, habits and heritage. India's heritage advocates hospitality, charity, friendship, love, unselfishness, peace, mercy and tolerance. It helps the Indians live in unity, forgetting all the differences. Constitutional rights. Our constitution lays the foundation for national integration. Our constitution grants equality, freedom and justice to all the citizens of India. Fundamental rights are guaranteed to the people irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and race. Privileges are given to the weaker sections like scheduled caste and tribes. The value of socialism and secularism have greatly helped the cause of national integration. Every Indian should work together to promote the above concepts. National festivals. National festivals like Independence Day, Republic Day, National Integration Day and Gandhi Jayanti are celebrated by the people of our country. We celebrate these festivals in our schools, colleges and offices. National flag and national anthem. All Indians give respect to our national flag, which represents to our courage, sacrifice, truth, peace and prosperity. We are inspired by national anthem in which we sing about the greatness of India. Our national song Vande Mataram induces the spirit of patriotism. Regional interdependence. Now come to the next page. Page number 136. We have different geographical features and climate in different states. The crop we grow differ from state to state. So there is exchange of goods and crops from one state to another. We get ivory from Kerala, betel leaf from Tamil Nadu and wheat from Punjab. Our national poets like Rabindranath Tagore, Subramanya Bhartiyar wrote many songs on national integration in Tamil languages. Feeling of oneness. The feeling that we are all Indians, that we are the sons of Bharat and that all Indians are my brothers and sisters help us to promote national integration. United we live, divided we fall is the spirit that safeguards the national integration. Factors disrupting national integration. Though we take pride in our national unity, we still face various factors which blocks the growth of national integration in India. So, communalism. In our country, communities are formed on the basis of religions. Communalism refers to the selfish, aggressive attitude of one community towards another. This feeling sometimes leads to communal riots. Thousands of innocent people die during these communal riots. So the Indian citizens should develop the spirit of religious tolerance and the feeling of oneness. Linguism. In 1956, India was divided into many states on the basis of languages. These states are called linguistic states. In general, people of India have great love for their mother tongue. Sometimes they develop narrow-minded approach towards other languages and hate them. Therefore, we must show our respect to other languages, which helps to unite the people who speak different languages. Casteism. Casteism hinders our national integration. All men are born equal before God and law. Casteism is against this principle. In India, caste systems originated in a simple form during the Vedic period. Caste system is based on the principles of Varna, which divided the society into four groups: Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, and Shudras. In due course of time, the Varna system gave rise to many castes and subcastes. Hence, the feeling of superiority and inferiority began to develop in the minds of the people. People of higher caste hesitated to mix or to make social contacts with the people of lower caste. This hinders the smooth functioning of a democracy and the growth of nationality. On the growth of national integration. This is the reading of the chapter. You have to read this VAPA and also read these fact zones. These are available on the pages. Yeah. So, aapko ye read karne hai. Or in the next video, I'll explain this chapter. Till then, thank you class and have a nice day. Goodbye.